In this next video, we're going to look at some more problems regarding electric charge. And this is just a concept problem. Note the fixed charges and positions in the figure. So we have a positive 8Q charge on this particle 1. A distance L from that, we'll have particle 2 with a charge negative 2 times Q. Where should a proton be placed to be in static equilibrium? Now, a proton is going to be positively charged. What will happen if we put it here to the left of particle 1? Well, certainly there'll be a force on it in this direction. Let's get a pen. It'll be a force in this direction. Quite large, because it's quite close to a very large positive charge. This negative charge, which is going to pull our third particle in the towards the right, is going to be a lot weaker. Certainly the charge is a lot smaller, and the distance now between particle 3 and particle 2 is way larger than between particle 3 and particle 1. So there'll always be a net force in this direction, so no static equilibrium. What if we put a positive charge here? Well, it's going to be pulled, a positive charge here, a proton, we said, in this direction, but it's also going to be pushed away in this direction by charge 1. So no matter where you put it in between, there'll always be a net force in that direction. That leaves us on this side. A positive charge here is obviously going to be repelled by force 1. It's a hell of a lot further away than particle 2, but it's also a bigger charge, plus 8. It's going to be pulled to the left by the attractive force of the negative, or the oppositely signed charge particle to the left. So this is where we might find our static equilibrium. So set the proton as charge 3, and it must be to the right of Q2 to be in static equilibrium. If we just look at it to work it out, if it's positively charged, the proton, the force on particle 3 from particle 1 is going to be, we said, in the positive x direction. The force on particle 3 due to particle 2 is going to be attractive force, and we said we're putting it on the right, so that will be in the left. And we want it to be in static equilibrium, so if we add these two forces by the law of superposition, that should equal 0. We know an equation for the force between electrically charged particles from Coulomb's law. And if we look at this, well, let's just look at the denominator here, the distance between them. So particle 3 to particle 1, if we put particle 3 here to particle 1, is this going to be at whatever x value we have? If we look at the distance between 3 and 2, so this distance here, it is going to be x minus L. So it's the full length minus the shorter length, and that's going to leave us this distance. That's why it's x minus L. Certainly charge 3 will cancel out, so we have charge 1, which is 8Q, the magnitude of charge Q2, which is 2Q. So don't put the negative there. This is magnitude, absolute value. Do not make that mistake. We just multiply across and simplify. Do that for yourself. Very simple algebra. We shouldn't get stuck on that. And we'll get that the x value at which a proton will be in static equilibrium should be twice 2L, twice the distance of those particles 1 and 2 from each other. So that's a very simple problem. Let's just look at one more for this video. Two particles with identical charges are initially held 3.2 times 10 to the power negative 3 meters apart. The first has a mass of 6.3 times 10 to the power negative 7 kilogram. If the first initially accelerates at 7 meters per second, well, let's do that. This is quite a longer problem. We'll leave that for the next video.